further curbs on black money by passing a bill to tackle the Benami property menace. Now, the bill not only has stringent provisions for the punishment, but also hefty fines, while sparing genuine religious institutions which hold properties.
Minister may now move that the bill as amended.
In what should send alarm bells ringing for holders of Benami properties, Lok Sabha passed Benami Transactions Prohibition Amendment Bill on Wednesday. It entails imprisonment of up to 7 years for violators and aims to effectively prohibit Benami transactions and consequently prevent circumvention of law through unfair practices. While tabling the bill, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley warned of strict action against those possessing Benami properties.
The Standing Committee suggested that the word should be known sources and not known sources of income, because if a person is accused of having acquired a Benami property, he can legitimately say that this is not my income. I have borrowed this money from a bank. I have taken this money from another family member. And if he is able to show that, that's a legitimate defense. So the sources would be known, though it would not be a sources of his income. It was a correct suggestion which has been made.
Real estate, especially land, has for long been a preferred place for parking black money. Any property held by a person on behalf of the real owner for any gain is called Benami. A property transaction in a fictitious name or in which the owner claims no knowledge of the arrangement is also a Benami deal and will be covered by the legislation. Those involved, including the real owner and the person who holds the property, can be awarded a jail term of up to 7 years, along with a fine of 25% of market value of the Benami property. Exemptions have been given in some cases relating to properties of Hindu undivided families and trusts. Submission of false information can invite jail term of up to 5 years, along with a fine of up to 10% of the value of the Benami property. The bill got the support of majority of political parties during the discussion, who demanded strong action by the government against black money.
Is bill mein jo pravidhan hai nishchit roop mein wo jo kale dhan ko kamane wale hain desh ko lootne wale hain उन पर शिकंजा कसने के लिए और उनको इस कानून के अंदर लाने के लिए ये व्यवस्था की गई, जो अपने आप में सशक्त तो है।
शिकंजा कसने के लिए कड़े प्रावधान का भी उपाय किया गया है और उसके लिए सजा का भी इंतजाम किया गया है। यह जरूरी है इसलिए कि बेनामी संपत्ति और बेनामी धन बड़े भीतर भीतर कैंसर की तरह प्रवेश करता है और देश को खाता है, देश के समृद्धि को खाता है। रियल एस्टेट में बड़े जो है कारोबारी चालाकी से जो है पैसे लगा देते हैं।
I appreciate the movement of the government, where now we have proper authorities, proper investigating officers in terms of the initiating officer, the approving authority, an administrator, and an adjudicating authority.
Responding to the discussion on the bill, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said that the Benami Transactions Prohibition Act was enacted in 1988. However, detailed rules were not laid down and the law was not effective. Responding to suggestions of members on why the government has not come out with a new law in place of the 1988 Act, the minister said such a move would have given immunity to persons who acquired Benami properties during the period from 1988 to 2016.
Why did we not bring a new law? Because a new law would have meant giving immunity to everybody from the penal provisions during the period 1988 and 2016, and giving a 28-year immunity would not have been in larger public interest, particularly if large amounts of unaccounted and black money has been used to transact those transactions itself. That was the principal object.
The bill clearly defines Benami property and has specific provisions on punishment, fine and appeal. Since Benami property is used as a tool to hide black money, a crackdown on those keeping Benami property will predominantly be an anti-black money measure. With Parliament team, DD News.